I love all kinds of animals, I always have, and I particularly love domestic animals. They fit beautifully out here at the Garden Home Retreat. But if you've ever tried to raise domestic animals, you know that often you have to figure out ways to keep them from being poached by predators. And that's certainly the case with many of my waterfowl species we have here. Some of the most elegant are the swans. We have 5 mute swans, and I felt like before I got them, I really needed to get a system in place to keep predators from getting their eggs. And here in early spring, they're particularly vulnerable because the females are making nests and laying eggs. And so they are vulnerable to bobcats, coyotes, and foxes jumping them and taking them, and then certainly the eggs, and raccoons and possums love those. So what I've created here is a series of corrals that during this period they can be housed comfortably, they can lay their eggs, they can hatch out their little nestlings, and then they can mature to the point we can turn them loose on the pond and there they'll be safe. Now the waterfowl breeds we have out here currently include those curly feathered geese called Sebastopols and an adorable little duck which is black and white called a magpie, which happens to be a very good layer. And then the most majestic of them all, I suppose, would have to be the mute swans. And this time of year, when they begin to create their nests, well, they can be a little ornery to deal with. Now, don't let their elegant, graceful appearance fool you. They can be fierce defenders of their nests. But you know, even with that said, it's important for me to create a system here that actually protects them. It's important to take care of the things that you have. And I also think this certainly applies to wildlife. So it's encouraging to me that we have people such as Karen Rao who are working on behalf of migratory birds.
Well, today was an experiment to take 9-month-old trumpeter swan cygnets, bringing them south in the hopes that they will stay and imprint on this wintering site in the late winter, return back north to Iowa to their natal or their birth territories, remain there through the summer months, and then return back here in the fall to winter again. What we're doing here is restoring a native North American species back to the United States, and families can teach their children by going out and experiencing the opportunity to see these trumpeter swans through the Mississippi Flyway, everywhere from Wisconsin down here through Missouri and Iowa and Arkansas. Their families can take their children and teach them about the value of wetlands, the value of having North America's largest waterfowl, and kids, when they see this beautiful big white bird, just are in awe of it. North America's largest bird, the trumpeter swan, 8-foot wingspan, 35 pounds. One of the guys say he is a 42-pound swan on his property. People learn and love the things that they know and see, and teaching children about wildlife comes from letting them experience things such as seeing their first wild trumpeter swan. Every bird species is the piece of the puzzle that makes, when it's fit together, it makes the whole ecosystem, and the healthy ecosystem, we depend on it just like wildlife. And when we have a wetland system that's healthy enough to support swans, then we know it's healthy enough to support us and our children. They'll breed at 3 or 4 years of age, so hopefully they'll go back north when they're 3 and 4, breed and bring their young back, and thus establish that pattern of migration. Well, I think down the line, the real benefit are our children, who will be able to then come out and say, this is a piece of our heritage that we've restored here to Arkansas, that we've restored to the flyway. Wildlife is the puzzle piece of the planet, all the different species. And when you take that final piece, that trumpeter swan piece, and you put it in that puzzle, and you have the whole connected again, you're healthy, everything's right with the world. And when you can look at a trumpeter swan and hear him flying over, it's indescribable. It means the earth is whole, the earth is good, and all is right with the world.